Hello, and you're very welcome back to MPS Goes To Westport Festival. I'm sitting here with the wonderful Mundy. Mundy, how are you?
Good, thank you.
So, you've just finished playing, Mundy. How did it go?
Very well, very well. It's kind of like something I've been looking forward to all year.
Oh, really?
Yeah, these festivals kind of in Ireland, like whichever one you choose to do or get, but it's kind of like your chance to kind of shine. So, for me, it was a bit, you know, big day.
And why do you think that is?
Like you play, you know, when I play all over the country in various different venues, various different sizes, this is like you get to play to 3,000 or 4,000 people or more or whatever, like that tent, I don't know what it holds, 3,000 or 4,000. But it's like a capsule, you know, it's compact and you get an hour.
Yeah.
I mean, I had to drop a few of my favourite songs, you know, today to squash them all in.
And it must be great to hear those 3,000 or 4,000 people singing your songs back to you.
Yeah, it's mad. I mean, I still get quite nervous or uptight about these events because if you drop the ball at all, I always feel like it's kind of like an exam nearly. I don't know, I have a really stupid way of looking at it. But like, I keep forgetting that I have a kind of a repertoire of songs that actually I shouldn't even have to worry anymore, you know, especially on a beautiful day like July or Mexico or, you know, having to call a girl it was brilliant.
July was off 24-star hotel that went more than triple platinum, which was amazing. Can you tell me a little bit about that record?
Strange. I put my first album in 1996 and then I got dropped by the record label. I made 24-star hotel in 1999, I think, and then in the year 2000 the record label were getting rid of, you know, a couple of hundred bands off their roster, and I was one of them, and I couldn't get the album back from them.
So they actually dropped you before 21st Hour?
Yeah, but I recorded it for them. And then legally I had a little, you know, thing, and I got it back, and I only put it out in 2002.
Oh, so it was actually written for...
So it was meant to come out in 1999 or 2000. So anyway, long story short, I released it myself on my own record label after I got it back, and July just became this kind of... Like it was like the new flu, it just kind of went viral, you know.
And I'd say that the record company were fairly kicking themselves after seeing
that. Yeah, in fairness, they were really into that song. That was the one song they said that was a hit. And I was like, the chorus isn't finished. I was like, who's going to listen to Oh My Mama in July? And it just stuck. You
know, really did. So back to present day, you're recording a new album at the minute. Mm. Can you release any information about that yet?
Oh yeah, I can chat away about it. The guy who produced my first album is a guy called Youth, and he's in a band called Killing Joke. He produced Urban Hymns by The Verve, and he's worked with Paul McCartney and, you know, loads of people like Echo and the Bunnymen or whatever. And I hadn't seen him in 16 years since the 2 weeks we spent in Wales on my first album. And I went in to see him in the Button Factory, his band, and I went up to him, he was selling CDs after it, and I was like, all right, man. And he's like, no idea who I was. I was like, are you familiar looking? You know, I was like, I'm Mundy. And he said, no way, I thought I'd see you again. So anyway, he said, why don't you come over to London and do a bit of writing? So I was telling him that I just had two kids and I had a bit of a writer's block and, you know, managing myself and doing it all on my own. He goes, nah, you got to come over and we'll sort that out. So we went off to Spain in January of this year and we started the album and it's nearly mixed now. You know?
Whoa, well, that sounds very interesting.
So I'm just trying to figure out the strategy of how I'm going to put it out there and the whole lot, you know. Yeah.
So when can we expect that new album?
I'm not sure. Because it's very hard now to put out a record, you know. If your songs are really strong, you can miss the boat, you know what I mean? So it's all about planning and, you know, you could send a song to radio and it might get played and then all of a sudden the album's over. And so I just have to be careful. But I'd like to have something up online before Christmas.
Right.
And then maybe out next year the whole album. But it's getting scarier. It's getting scarier the whole time, you know.
Yeah, well, brilliant. Well, we look forward to hearing that. Mundy, thanks a million for chatting to us. Thanks. So that was Mundy here at MPS Goes to Westport Festival.